German Expressionism is an art movement that emerged in Germany and was mostly developed during the very first 20th century. It wasn't only a movement that influenced cinema, but also architecture, literature, and, above all, painting. It started as a way to evade themselves from the actual world for the artists, as Germany was deeply sunk into a huge crisis, both political and social, because of the struggles of the First World War, mainly. In the cinema, German Expressionism was mostly developed during the 20s, a convulsive period in Germany, where the directors wanted to show the social unrest for the conditions of life of the post-war ages. The three main directors of this movement are Robert Wiene, Fritz Lang, and F.W. Murnau. The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari tends to be considered as the initial film of this movement, and is one of the most relevant and influential ones, alongside Metropolis, Nosferatu, and Faust. It has been a common influence to very famous filmmakers since its appearance, like Orson Welles, Carol Reed, and, above all, Alfred Hitchcock. These directors didn't include direct allusions, but they had clear influences, like the play of lights and shadows and the creation of phantasmagorical and scary places, like German Expressionist directors did. In modern cinema, German Expressionism is still a common reference point for many filmmakers. The most famous case is the one of Tim Burton, whose most popular movies contain characters and sets that have several striking similarities to these German films of the 20s. From sets that look like those which were created by Wiene or Lang, to scenes that are exactly the same to those of films like Nosferatu or The Cabinet of Dr. Caligari. Many other contemporary directors include clear references to this movement among their filmography. Guillermo del Toro is one of them, mainly in one of his masterpieces, The Pan's Labyrinth, in which he presents several strange creatures with expressionist appearance, and in The Devil's Backbone. Alex Proyas, the Australian filmmaker, mimics some of the lighting techniques and aesthetics that were used by the expressionists, like he does in his movie Dark City. There are authors that unusually add fantastic elements in their films, but have also included expressionist references, such as Woody Allen. As German expressionism aesthetic is very flashy, it has also influence on the creation of music video clips, a type of videos that are mostly focused on the visual part and not in the narrative. The most obvious example is the video clip of Red Hot Chili Peppers, which seems to be set in a very similar city to Metropolis one. We can also appreciate this influence in Metallica's The Unforgiven, or in the Sound of Silence version by Disturbed.
Oh, wait, what about this one?